Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Hello, this is Jacob Wilson, and today I'm going to be recording some standard matches with Mono Blue. I just played Grand Prix Chicago, where I played this exact 75. I went 13-2. That includes three buys. And I missed top 8 because of tiebreakers, but I had the same record as 3rd through 10th place. I think the deck's very good, and without much changing, or assuming that not much will change in M15, I think Mono Blue is definitely going to be the top, one of the top contenders for the rest of the standard season. This is a pretty standard configuration of Mono Blue. Except whereas most decks have a Hall of Triumph, I'm decided to play one Hypnotic Siren. It's nice to have a card that can randomly win you a game when you get flooded to 7 mana. And I also just like having another cheap creature. It's not that different than Judge's Familiar or Cladfin Raptor, though it is admittedly worse. And against Mono Black, I think it's quite good. If they're all playing four Devour Flesh, it's really nice to have a one mana creature to gain a mana advantage against their Devour Flesh. In the sideboard, most of the cards are devoted to the control matchup. Because Mono Blue is a synergy based deck, you really cannot sideboard very much. So I like to limit myself to sideboarding two or three cards in every matchup, except for control. So the cards that you normally board in are Cyclonic Rift, Domestication, and Curse of the Swine. Some combination of these against creature decks. And then for the control matchup, you have 2 Dispel, 4 Gainsay, 1 Negate, 2 Dissolve, and 2 Jaces. So that's 9 counterspells and 2 big Planeswalkers. And in the control matchup, you can board out Cloudfin Raptor and Master of Waves, because they tend to lead to getting blown out by Supreme Verdict. And then against the creature matchups, you just have a few cards that interact. Normally, I like to take out Biden of Thassa on the draw, and Thassa, God of the Sea, against Burn, but not against any other matchup. And whenever you're unsure, you can trim one Tidebinder Mage or one Frostburn Weird. Alright, hopefully the standard 8-man will start soon.